Welcome you all, Government of Karnataka and the Department of Collegiate and Technical Education has organized a video session for various subjects. In this video session, we are going to cover a course Engineering Mechanics and Strength of Materials. It comes for third semester in Civil Engineering program or Civil Engineering department. In this course Engineering Mechanics and Strength of Materials, we are covering first unit, that is Introduction to Engineering Mechanics. I once again welcome you all. Let's move on to next slide. Table of content. These are all the topics going to be covered in this video session. First one, the Introduction to Engineering Mechanics and importance of strength of material. Why strength of material? Why we have to study strength of material? Then force and its unit. The effect of various effects of forces and characteristics of force. Force system and its classifications. And to assess the above topic, last some multiple choice questions. Engineering mechanics. First, let us know what is mechanics. It's a branch of science which deals with the effect of forces on different matters. Matters are solid, liquid, and gas. Solids and fluids. We differentiate the matter in solid into fluids, where fluids are gases and liquid. Again, repeat, what is mechanics? The mechanics is a branch of science which deals with the effect of forces on various different matters, that is solid or fluids. In any solids and fluids, which may be deformable or which may be rigid. Now coming to engineering mechanics. Engineering mechanics is a branch of engineering and technology which deals with the effect of forces on various static and dynamic structures. Both static and dynamic structures. Further, engineering mechanics is divided into two branches, the mechanics of fluids and mechanics of solids. The mechanics of solid fluids is, it deals with the effect of various forces, the effect of forces on fluids. I again repeat, the fluids are liquids and gases. It's a combination of liquids and gases. The mechanics of solids. Mechanics of solid is, it deals with the effect of forces on rigid body or deformable body. What is rigid body? Rigid body, body which does not, which deform under the effect of force, is called deformable body. That means their shape and size will be changed. Body which does not deform under the action of force, when force is applied on the body, it will not change its shape and size, it will be a rigid body. And if it changes its shape and size, when force is applied on, when it changes its shape and size, it becomes shorter or it will become elongated when force is applied on it, then this is called deformable body. I again repeat, the body, we are discussing about rigid and deformable body. What is rigid body? Rigid body is a body which does not deform under the action of load. Deformable body are those which deforms, which changes its shape and size when under the action of load. Okay, mechanics of solids is further classified or further divided into two, mechanics of rigid body and mechanics of deformed body. again repeat, the rigid body. What is rigid body? Rigid body which deforms under the, which do not deform under the action of load is called rigid body, which deforms under the action of force is called deformable body. The mechanics of rigid body deals with the effect of forces on rigid bodies. Effect of forces on rigid body. Mechanics of deformable body deals with the effect of forces on deformable, which body under the action of load, which deforms under the action of load. Next, the mechanics of rigid body is further divided into statics and dynamics. What is static? Static is a which does not move or which is in state of rest. The static is the body which is in state of rest. Dynamic, which is in motion. Body which is in motion. Next, the mechanics of deformable body is further divided into strength of material, theory of elasticity, and theory of plasticity. The theory of strength of material. Strength of material is a branch which deals with the effect of force on deformable body, which deforms. Then theory of elasticity. We have to know first what is elasticity and plasticity. Elasticity is when we put a load on a body, it deforms, and until when it remove, when the load is removed from the body, it will regain its shape and size. I can repeat, elasticity. What is elasticity? Elasticity is a property where the when the body is loaded, it will deform. A slight deformation will be there. After releasing the load, the deformation will regain its shape and size. Whatever the deformation, temporary deformation happened, that will regain its shape and size. The plasticity, which does not regain its shape and size. The body which, even after removing all of load, the body which does not regain its shape and size is called plasticity. This theory of plasticity deals with the elastic body, deals with the various effect of forces on elastic body. Theory of plasticity deals with the various effect of forces on elastic body. Next, we'll move to next slide. Importance of strength of material. Why we have to study the strength of material? We have to know the properties of the material and behavior of the material, how it behaves with external load, what all internal forces that will be generated while loading or during loading. We have to know that. In order to know the physical and strength performance of the material, here natural or man-made structures. Man-made structures in the sense bridges, dams, buildings, these are man-made structures. Whereas in man-made structures, there are some structural components such as beams, columns, which are made up of different materials, concrete, steel, etc. We have to know the strength performance or what how the each the structural component of different materials behaves when subjected to external load. Next, failures or selecting the material, appropriate material, what kind of material will withstand what amount of loads. We have to know that for that we need strength of material. It helps in selecting the processing of material to achieve better performance, for the better performance in order to withstand failure, and also helps in to know the ultimate strength of the material and at what load it breaks, which will be useful in design purpose, and guides for design of products against possible and probable failures. We move to next slide. Next is force. Force is an external agency which changes or tends to change the state of rest or uniform motion of the body. It's an external agency where any body, if it is in rest position, the force will change its position, or if it is in motion, it will make the movable body into the state of trust. That's why the force is an external agency which changes or which tends to change the state of rest of a body or a uniform motion of or a state of a uniform motion of a body. Okay. How will we measure the force? Here, force is also represented as a push or a pull. Force is directly proportional to the rate of velocity, that is acceleration. Here, force is directly proportional to the product of mass into rate of change of velocity. The mass here is constant, where the variables are force and change of velocity. When the force increases, the rate of change of velocity also increases. That's why, in mathematically, force is directly proportional to m, that is mass, a is acceleration, rate of change of velocity, and force, this implies force equals to k into m into a. Force is mathematically defined as it's a product of mass of an object and acceleration of mass. Force is a product of mass into acceleration, where k is the constant of proportionality, which is equals to 1. That's why that where F is force, M is the mass, and A is acceleration, and K is the constant of proportionality. Force is equal to mass into acceleration. Force. Force is a representation of action of on body as a push or a pull. It may be when body is pushed, it represents as a force, or if body is pulled, also it represents a force. As per the definition of force, it is a force, the tendency to move the body or body to rest. Force is a vector quantity. Okay, what is vector quantity now? Vector quantity, there are two types of quantity, scalar quantity and vector quantity. Scalar quantity is a quantity which has magnitude but no direction. Scalar quantity and vector quantity. In scalar quantity, it has only magnitude, but there will be no direction. But vector quantity has magnitude and also direction. Suppose force is considered as a vector quantity. It has particular direction and a magnitude. It is 10 kN is the magnitude and it has a direction. That's why the force is a vector quantity. In this figure, graphical representation of force, the boy which named as A, boy is named as A, is pulling the block. Boy is named as A is pulling the block, where boy is named as B is pushing the block, which both represent the both are action of so action on a body, which represent push or a pull. A represents the pull, where body moves in the A direction, or B represent also push, is pushing on its back, which goes in the again in a direction of A, where the arrow is indicated here. Okay, arrow is indicated here. F is the magnitude of force. Okay, that's why the force is a representation of action on body as a push or a pull. Unit of force. Unit of force is a Newton. Newton, what is Newton? It is defined as the amount of force required to move 1 kg of mass at an acceleration of 1 meter per second. As we have know that force is a product of mass into acceleration as per mathematical definition. When 1 kg of mass is one mass is equal to 1 kg, F is equal to mass into 1 kg, ma, F is equal to m into a, where mass is equal to 1 kg and acceleration is 1 meter per second square as per the above definition, then the product of 1 into 1 will be 1, then this force generated is 1 newton. 1 newton. Force is defined as the force that is required to move 1 kilogram of mass at an acceleration of 1 meter per second square. The 1 newton is equal to 1 kg mass into 1 meter per second square. F is equal to m into a. Thus, F in kg, kg weight is equal to m into g, where g is the acceleration due to gravity in falling objects under the influence of gravity. 1 kg weight is equal to 9.81 newtons. Thus, the 1 kg is equals to 10 newtons. Remember, 1 kg equals to 10 newtons. Next, the effects of forces. Effect of force or effects of forces. The force can change the shape and size of the body. The force can change the shape and size of the body. Here in graphical representation, the shape of the object is changed by applying a force on it, or applying the, he is hammering the sword and it will change its shape and size. Second example, the spring is loaded at the bottom, spring is loaded and it changes its shape and size. Look at the expansion over here, expansion of spring, where it changes the shape and size due to this load or due to this force. Next, the force can make a stationary object move. The body which is in rest, by applying the force on it, it can move or it will make body in motion. Here, in a carom board, the striker strikes the striker and all the pieces on the carom board will scatter, and which was in rest position, due to the force applied on the striker, all the other pieces will move. Thus the force can make the stationary object move. And here in this example, apple over here falls on the ground due to acceleration due to gravity. Thus the apple is in rest position in the inertia, and it drops and falls on the ground. Thus the stationary object moves. The force can change the direction of moving object. When bowler bowls the ball, the batsman strikes, which makes the direction of the ball, it was moving in one direction, and when batsman hits the ball, it will move in another direction. Thus the force can change the direction of the moving object. Next, force can stop the moving object. Here in this example, ball is thrown by another person, which the static ball is made to move, which is the force can second point. Force can make the stationary object move, and the other person catches the ball, which was in motion, and brings it to static condition, brings it to the rest. Therefore, the force can stop the moving object. And when car is moving, the person applies the brake, and suddenly by applying the brake, car stops. This shows that force can stop the moving object. Let's move on to the next slide. Characteristics of the force. The force is characterized by its magnitude, direction, point of application, and line of action. It is characterized by these four with an illustration diagram. When force is applied on a body or a pull is when you push the body, it will move in certain direction. When assume that I am pushing it in a 100 newton, I am applying 100 newton force on a body and it moves in a direction, in this direction, body is moving in this direction. Therefore, 100 newton is a magnitude here and it is moving in a this direction. And point of application is here, I name it as A. The A is a point of application and line of application is this one. The direction and the point of application is also called as combination of these two, also called as line of application, where this is the force applied direction and the point of where the exactly the force is applied. I clear this again. Force is characterized by magnitude, direction, point of application and line of application. Here in this object, let us give another example where this as an object or a body where force is applied, 100 kilonewton force applied, where 100 is the magnitude of the force, this one is magnitude of the force, and arrow indicates the direction of the force, which tends the body to move in this direction, downward direction, and the point of application is A, where in this point is where exactly the force is applied, and line of application is this is the line of application where it includes both direction and point of application. Here direction and point of application together is defined as line of action. Again, example force applied, what we have shown there in the graphical representation. Following characteristics are shown in the figure, but magnitude is 100 kN as I earlier said. Second one, the point of application is A, where the force is exactly applied. And third one, the line of action is vertical. Line of action is vertical towards downward direction. And direction is downward. Okay. First, the magnitude is 100 kN and direction is in this direction, downward direction. The point of application is A, where it indicates A, and line of action indicates this one. This is the line of action. I repeat once again. Force is 100 kN, magnitude of the force is 100 kN, and the direction is downward direction. The point of application is A, where the load is applied, and line of application is, it's a combination of point of application and direction of the force. This is line of application. Next, we'll move to next slide. Force system. What is force system? It's a combination of two or more forces are called force system. All the forces acting on an object constitute a system of force. And when force is acting on a body or in a plane, in different directions, the combination of all these forces is called system of force. There are many system of forces. Suppose we take a body, the force is applied here, and if you consider a three-dimensional body, let us say three-dimensional body, the force is applied in this direction, or force is applied on here, on the above the body, and there is this all force constitute a system of force. There are many, it is classified into many system or many force systems. We will discuss one by one. Classification of force system according to plane and line of action. In which plane is lying the force, the various forces which we are discussing now, which lies in which plane and their line of action. Depending upon this, we are classifying the force system. The force is classified into coplanar forces and non-coplanar forces. What is coplanar forces? Coplanar forces, suppose we consider a plane. What is plane? Plane is a two-dimensional object, a two-dimensional quantity, where space body is a three-dimensional entity. Space is where force acting in a plane. It's a two-dimensional figure where space is three-dimensional. Where quantity volume comes under three dimension, area is two dimension. So plane comes under area. So coplanar forces, when two or more forces acting in the same plane. For example, if we consider the x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis, if we consider the four xy plane, when force is acting in xy planes, however maybe it is acting depending on not depending upon the direction, force is acting on all on one plane, this is called coplanar forces. All these forces are called coplanar forces. So for force is acting in xz plane, these forces are which is acting together are called also coplanar forces in their plane. In yz plane, these forces are coplanar force. But when we compare the force which is in xy plane and xz plane, they are not coplanar forces. They are lying in a different plane. Here, these are all coplanar forces with respect to the xy plane. These are all coplanar forces with respect to the xz plane. But when we compare which is in two different planes, compare these forces with these forces, but they are not coplanar forces because they are lying in the two different planes. They are non-coplanar forces. The force, number of forces or system of force which lies in same plane is called coplanar forces. And the non-coplanar force, which are force which lying on different planes, are called to me non-coplanar force. Next, the coplanar forces are further divided into four kinds of forces: collinear forces, concurrent forces, non-concurrent forces, and parallel forces. The collinear forces, again, if we consider a single plane, because it's a coplanar forces, single plane, when force is lying in a same line, that means the same line, force is lying in a same line, the force is acting in a same plane, same line of action, all the forces has the same line of action. Then these forces are called collinear forces. Suppose the force which is in other direction these two forces, suppose we call this as a A, B or C, D, E, F, G. A, B, C, D are collinear forces. Even E, F, G are collinear forces, but A and E are not collinear forces because they have two different line of actions. Their line of actions are different. Okay. I hope you are clear. Next, concurrent forces. All are coplanar forces only. In concurrent forces, concurrent of suppose Y and X plane in X and Y plane. X and Y plane. Coplanar concurrent forces are the force which acting in a single point. The force which acts on at a single point, which acts at a single point, is called coplanar concurrent forces, which is in same plane and acting in at a same point. In XY plane, I will repeat again. When system of forces acting on a single point is called coplanar concurrent force, or force acting from a single point, these are also called as, which should be lying on same plane, also called as concurrent forces. There are two kinds of forces. The point coming towards the line are convergent forces, and other one are divergent concurrent forces. Okay, I'll repeat again. Once again, concurrent forces are the forces which act on a same point, is called concurrent forces. It may be convergent concurrent forces or divergent concurrent forces. Then non-concurrent forces, the force which has different point of application. Point of application are different. It lies in same plane but different point of application, where the force which are acting in a different point of application, different plane. Concurrent forces are those which acting in a same point. All the forces acting in the same point, these forces are called concurrent forces. Non-concurrent forces are, they are acting randomly, where they are not acting at a single point. Each force is acting at a different point of application. And parallel forces, coplanar parallel forces, when in the same plane, X Y plane, the parallel forces are force which act in a parallel direction. These are all force which acting in a same plane, which are parallel to each other. I name it as A, B, C, D, E, where A and B are parallel forces, A and C, or A, B, C, all A, B, C are parallel forces, but D and E are, they are parallel forces, but when compared to this one, they are also parallel forces, but there is difference between these forces, but which moves in upward direction. These forces are moving upward direction, but this one is in downward direction. All these forces are parallel forces, but when we have when two parallel forces have same direction, it is called as like parallel forces. When two forces which are in same direction, this is called like parallel forces. When two forces are in different direction, A and B, which are two forces which are in same direction, this is called parallel forces. C and D, which are opposite to each other, it is called unlike parallel forces. I'll repeat once again, error is solved. Okay. in a xy plane, two forces A, B, C, where A and B are all A, B, C are parallel forces, of course, but when we compare A and B, these are parallel like forces which are same direction. When we compare B and C, which is a parallel force but which has opposite direction, it is unlike parallel force. These are like parallel forces. Even compare this unlike parallel forces. Okay. I'll repeat once again. The force is classified into coplanar forces and non-coplanar forces, where coplanar forces are the force which lies in same plane. Non-coplanar forces are force which lies in different planes. When compare the force coplanar forces and coplanar forces, they are it is classified into collinear forces, concurrent forces, non-concurrent forces and parallel forces. Collinear forces which are same line of action, the concurrent forces which in acting all the forces acting on a single point, non-concurrent it has no single point, it is random direction, and parallel forces which are parallel in nature, two forces which are parallel in nature. This non-coplanar forces, so parallel forces, like parallel forces and unlike parallel forces. And non-coplanar forces is further classified into concurrent forces, and then that is non-coplanar concurrent forces. There is a difference between these concurrent forces, where this is coplanar concurrent forces. Here, non-coplanar concurrent forces and non-coplanar non-concurrent forces and non-coplanar parallel forces. Suppose first concurrent forces, non-coplanar concurrent forces. When you take three-dimensional, x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, when force is acting, this is in xy plane, force is acting in the xy plane, and here also force is acting here in the same point of application, origin. Here also when force is acting, look at this, all forces, this force A, this force B and this force C are all in different planes. A is in xy plane, B is in xz plane and yz plane, C is acting in yz plane. But even though they are in different planes, that is non-coplanar, they are acting at the same point, that is called non-coplanar concurrent forces. I hope you understood. Then non-concurrent forces, we'll take same example, y direction, x plane and z plane. Non-coplanar non-concurrent forces, force acting in this direction, force one other force acting in this direction, random forces. This has a separate point of application. Our line of application are different. The line of doesn't pass in single point. That point of application are totally different. All the force point application is different, which also lies in a different plane. That's why it's called non-coplanar forces. All the forces are in different plane, and non-concurrent forces, which does not intersect in single point or does not meet at single point. Next, parallel forces with non-coplanar parallel forces. In this non-coplanar parallel forces, x plane, y and z. In non-coplanar parallel forces, suppose force acting in xy plane is in this direction, call it as A, and even in yz plane, which is parallel to this AB forces, which is parallel to A forces, which lies on other plane. Y, Z, I cannot show this, it will be wrong. Okay, A force which is in XY plane, which is named as A, and force is in XZ plane, which is in different plane, perpendicular planes, but they are two forces are in same direction and it is parallel to each other. Suppose the parallel, I'll write other plane, which is C here only. This one is coplanar. These are coplanar parallel forces. Coplanar parallel. But A and B, when we compare A and B, these are non-coplanar, which is in different plane, and they are parallel forces. Okay. Let's move on to multiple choice question. One, a force while acting on a body may change its motion or balance the force already acting, give rise to the internal stresses. Fourth, all of them. Yeah, we know that we have studied in the four effect of forces, that force will, that is various force effect of forces, it will change the body motion, change its motion or motion of the body, and balance the force already acting, yeah, and give rise to the internal stresses. Yes, it will change the shape and size of the body, where the change of shape and size of the body, the body where internal stress will be generated, yes. And all of this, yeah, all these are correct. That's why the option D, all of these. Let's move on to next MCQ, multiple choice question. Second one, in order to determine the effects of force acting on body, we must know the magnitude of the force, line of action of the force, nature of force, pull or push, or all of the above. In order to determine the effect of force acting on a body, we must know the magnitude of force. We have to know the magnitude of the force. Yeah, we have to know the line of action of the force, in which direction it moves, the nature of the force, yeah, pull or push, and all the above. This one also, all the above. Third one, the unit of force in SI system of unit is, first one, dyne, B, kilogram, C, newton, and watt, D, watt. Of course, answer is newton. We have studied in the unit of force slide, it's newton. The unit of force is newton. Fourth one, the concurrent force are those force whose line of action lie on the same plane, meet at one point, meet on the same plane, and none of these. Lie on the same line. It has first, if it doesn't, concurrent force doesn't lie on the same plane, the line, force which lie on the same line is collinear force. Collinear forces, same line, it is called collinear forces. Collinear forces meet at one point. Yeah, force which acts and meet at one point is called concurrent forces. Which act at a single point is concurrent. Meet at same plane action, meet on the same plane, then same plane, then concurrent forces will be in same plane also. Yeah, both. Meet at one point, same thing. More appropriate answer is B. Let's see. Yeah. Concurrent force are those force whose line of action meet at one point. We have come to the end of the session. Thank you. I'd like to acknowledge our team. All the members of our team who have helped in preparing this video session, study material, and in all aspects. I special thanks to my my sir Dr. Chandigiri Gowda and M.S. Chandrasekhar sir and Tejamurthy sir for helping in keen thorough review and making this video. Thank you one and all.